This episode of the Poormans Pinball Podcast is proudly brought to you by This Week in Pinball. Go to This Week in Pinball for all your pinball news. It's where we steal all our shit from Jeff Patterson, and we tell you all about it. Like this week, Avengers reveal videos, Deeproot announces launch date, Raymond Davidson interview, and the Pinball Pig. That is all you're going to see this week on TWIP for September 14th, 2020. Some really good stuff on there. Jeff Patterson always has the best pinball news, and we love him for it. We are also brought to you by Pinshades. Don't forget about our friend Jockton. Go to Pinside and check out Pinshades. Use the code POORMANS at checkout for 10% off your order.
That's with an S.
With an S. Don't also forget about pinballprices.com, our buddy Doc Finlay. He got in with a bottle of booze, as we like to say, but his site is awesome. You're buying a machine, you're selling a machine, go to pinballprices.com. He logs in every single sale. He logs in what he thinks the prices are. It's a great resource for any time you are buying or selling a machine. Go to Flipping Out Pinball. You want a new pinball machine? Flipping Out Pinball. Call Zach. Get yourself a new machine. Get yourself a used machine. Get yourself an Escalera stair climbing hand truck. But you know what? He sells some great, great machines. So check it out, Flipping Out Pinball. And last, but certainly not least, as always, Pinstadium Lights. I just got my Neo Fusions in the mail. They look great in the box. I haven't unboxed them yet, but I'm sure they're going to look fantastic on my machine. Pinstadium, Neo Fusions, they got flashers. They got all kinds of cool things. They interact with your game. They work on any pinball machine. Go to Pinstadium Lights. Tell Scott we sent you. Use Poor Man with no S at checkout for 10% off your order. That'll give you free shipping and more, so buy some accessories. I will report back next week when I put those Neo Fusions in my Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and I'm sure they will be spectacular.
He's name-dropping like a motherfucker. Ah!
An upset tummy, otherwise known as a burning, itching butthole? Well, whenever I get done drinking a bottle of hot sauce or licking the side of a butter cab in the basement of some seedy Milwaukee bar, I always turn to the one and only cure that I know is going to help me get through such troubled times. The Poor Man's Pinball Podcast.
Holy shit, we did it.
We did what?
We're live.
We're here.
I think we're live.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
uh-oh.
God damn it.
Oh, God damn it. Can they hear us?
Yeah, I think they can hear us.
Okay. Fine. Well, hey, guys. We're here, episode 72. Poor Man's Pinball Podcast, the only podcast that thinks beer tasting makes great audio for
there
a
pinball
podcast.
We're good.
Oh, Ian saved the day with his technical support, as always.
Welcome to episode number 72, the Poor Man's Pinball Podcast, the only episode, or the only podcast, just to say, that decided that drinking beer on air as a taste test is super entertaining for our podcast listening audience.
Here's the thing. It wasn't super entertaining, but it was so much fun for me.
Yes. I think I do. Yeah. No, it was. It was. It was entertaining.
Now, I look at myself on this camera, and I am a beautiful man. We can all agree on that, right?
Gorgeous.
I am just a beautiful, sexy man.
Yep.
I feel like I get redder every single week.
Is it the booze, or is it the walls, or is it just... Yeah.
This episode of the Poor Man's Pinball Podcast is also brought to you by the Super Awesome Pinball Show.
No, it's not.
No, it's not. Sorry, Franchi. That was my shameless plug for
you. Can't afford us. So they're the ones that give you a red face? Is that the whole deal?
No. Okay. No, but I keep
looking. No correlation, kids.
I always look at the bright lights on my red face, and most people say, well, Drew's drunk all the time, so that's why. Nope, not true. Well, that is true, but I just have a red face. It's just the way I am. It's the way I'm built, Ian.
Yeah, I know.
So
yeah. I think it's gorgeous.
Yeah.
Gorgeous.
Welcome to my red face.
Oh, Drew. So, man, how you doing, man? What's up?
It's been a week, man.
It's been a week, yeah. Fuck yeah, it has.
It's been a week. So what you been up to?
Shit, dude. I've been rocking and rolling. kicking some ass. But before we get into our poor man's personal pinball news, why don't we get into what we're drinking?
Week number three.
Is the bottle done yet?
Almost. See that? Look at that. There's not much left. This is Amador. I may polish it off tonight. I may not. This stuff is really good. I haven't made a mixed drink here in like 3 weeks. I've just been drinking this, and it's fantastic. So Amador Whiskey Company, do you want to be a sponsor? You could replace Kessler, who's still not a sponsor.
Still not a sponsor. Amador. I still got a shit ton of Kessler, by the way.
Do you really?
Well, I bought like a 2 gallon jug.
Where is it? I never
saw
it.
Oh, it's under the...
Oh!
I'll have to get it out
for
you.
I don't want that shit now.
I know. You got expensive taste, motherfucker.
Amador Whiskey Company, be our sponsor. And we'll just label you expensive shit. How's that?
Ooh.
This will be my slogan. Amador Whiskey. I love expensive shit. Good? No?
It's gorgeous. Okay. Gorgeous. You did it.
What are you drinking, sir?
I killed some bamboo.
Bamboo? Bamboo.
Rum. So I got that going for me. But I am going to go into this George Ocean coconut rum, which is actually goddamn tasty.
I had that, a month or so ago. It is pretty good.
And then a little bit of Coke, and there's the cocktail. There's our poor man's glass, brought to you by Drew's wife, beautiful wife.
I was just about to say, Kathleen, if you're listening or if you're not listening.
Thank you, it holds booze.
Yes. My wife gave us these awesome glasses last week as a anniversary gift for Ian and I. We celebrated 18 years of... hetero life partner marriage, and slappiest show on the internet. Thank you very much, wife.
We're doing Love good. Thanks, wife. All right, so let's get into our poor man's personal pinball news.
And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. Of course, I'm talking about the Poor Man's Pinball Podcast personal pinball news.
All right, Drew, what do you got for poor man's personal pinball news,
buddy? So it feels like the last year and a half I've been talking about buttoning up Meteor.
Yes.
Right?
You have.
And
we're all enthralled with it.
There's a bit of a lie there. I wasn't buttoning it up. It was just in my garage.
You were blaming the heat.
I was blaming the heat. It was really hot.
It's been really cold
sure.
lately.
So last week, I finally went in there. Mm-hmm. I put the damn play field back in the cabinet. I put all the posts on. I bought those glow-in-the-dark rubbers. Titan Pinball, shout out. Not a sponsor, but love them.
Always love glow-in-the-dark rubbers. You know where you are in the dark.
Yeah. So I bought a set of glow-in-the-dark rubbers.
You're disgusting.
I put the flippers on. I put the rubbers on. They look really good. I put all the posts on. I fixed up a few of the large holes that I had to patch up and
fixing large holes.
Yep. So
the dark rubbers.
So a couple more things now. I still haven't got the powder coat. I got to bring them down to the powder coat guy. I just haven't done it, but I'm there. So a couple more days, get the powder coat. I'm good to go. So Meteor and now I got Stars out last week. So right. So Meteor is going to come back in the house and I'm going to enjoy Meteor for a little while.
Nice.
So. But another update on Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. That game is still brutally hard. It hasn't changed in a week.
Still incredibly hard.
Every day.
Every day.
Kicks my ass. Every day.
Gotcha.
So that's what I've been doing, though.
Okay.
What about you?
I bought 2 pinball machines. 2. Actually, 3.
3?
3. I bought 3. On Pinball FX3, I got... A Circus Voltaire. what is it? Tales of the Arabian Nights and No Good Gophers.
What did you pay for that?
$20.
So for all you guys who ever bought one of those 3 machines and spent $6,000 to $8,000 on it, you guys are suckers because Ian got it for $10.
I get to play it via the internet on a keyboard. Best way to play pinball.
Totally. By far. Oh my God.
No, I've been having fun this week, like later at night. I've been streaming some Pinball FX3 just because one, I wanted to get our numbers up.
Why don't we explain that to the people just so they know what you're doing here?
Pinball FX or what are you talking about?
No, streaming on Facebook Live.
So Facebook Live has a requirement that we need to hit a certain amount of hours of streaming within a certain amount of days. And we're able to get stars. So what are stars? Stars are exactly that. They're like you know, on Twitch they have what are they, bits?
Can we say that on Facebook? Bits.
Yeah, they have bits here.
Are we gonna get banned for saying that?
Now we have stars. So for the time being, we're all set up, I believe, with stars. So you guys can purchase stars. They work the same as bits, and you can boom boom. Give us money.
Wait. So our people today can purchase stars?
I think so. We're all set up for it. I don't know if it's very obvious on the stream. We'll have to look at it and see how it looks.
Yeah, that wasn't a shameless plug. We really don't know.
We don't know. So if you guys can give us some stars, let us know it works. Please do.
Give us some of your bits. I mean, but, stars. Don't cancel us, Facebook, please. Yeah.
But no, we're so I've been doing the Pinball FX3 because it's easy. Number one, to stream that real quick. But two, that shit's hard and stupid. I hate Pinball FX3. Just in general. Oh, I like it because it's like an easy way to play pinball real quick. But it's not pinball. It's hard. I hate nudging by pressing a button. Although my nudging is better by pressing a button.
Yeah, true enough. But we can all agree that playing some of the classic games and some of the like fun fantasy games on there don't exist. They're pretty cool.
Yeah, no, I get it. So I get it. I understand it. I don't like to do it, but I'm getting better at it. I'm going to continue to stream on it. I actually bought a little USB camera, you know, $20 on Amazon. So it's got a microphone on it. So you'll be seeing me with all the rest of the gamers on Facebook Gaming, and we're going to game and make millions of dollars and drive supercars and shit.
They play Fortnite. Ask Jack Danger about being a millionaire.
All right, I want to be a millionaire.
He's the biggest
playing video games.
He's one of the biggest streamers in pinball, and he's not a millionaire.
He's not a millionaire.
But the biggest streamer in Fortnite, he's a millionaire.
Millionaire.
Isn't that funny how that works?
God damn it.
Like, we got grown men working hard, doing their shit, and yeah, they're making some money, but not millions. And then this kid,
their rigs are pretty impressive.
Yeah.
These kids just hook up their computer and go.
Yeah, they just plug in their computer to their Xbox or their PS4 or 5, and they're like, yep, I'm doing Fortnite. So
Fortnite. Boom.
Check me out. Give me $1 million. All right.
I'm going to hop in my Ferrari and live stream from there. Boom. My Tesla. Boom.
Fucking A, man.
So that's what I did.
So stars. So we will have a more comprehensive stars plan going forward. Ian and I actually have some fun things. We're not just going to ask for money because that's just...
That's too much fun.
That's tacky.
I mean, yeah, tacky.
Yeah, yeah. But we're going to come up with some fun things that you guys can... And we're also going to do some charity events with it. So, you know, like I said, it's going to be all around good for everybody. Yeah. Ian's like, charity for my pockets.
All right. So anyway, let's get into some news. Shall we get into some news?
News.
All right, let's do news. All right, that was awkward and long, but here we go. So let's get started with Stern. Real simple. They're assembling the Avengers as we speak. So they've been shipping some stuff, yes. But they are full-on production. George Gomez actually had like a little post, and it was, Avengers assemble. So,
and it was the first pro rolling off the line.
Yeah, there was a shit ton of them all set up. So, very cool. I'm super excited about Stern just pumping them out again, just doing their thing. So, very impressive. What'd you think about Jack Danger's stream? Did you watch it?
I watched a good portion of it.
Okay.
And wow, is that a good game? I am very impressed with the amount that they put in that game.
Yeah.
I'm impressed with the wire forms.
Yes.
I'm impressed with the overall execution of everything with the shots and the animations and how the animations actually match the art pretty good.
I love the animations. I love that.
Because it looked like a comic book, right?
That artwork is pretty badass. Yeah. I think it looked better than a comic book.
Yeah.
It was somewhere in between like a good... I don't know, animated feature film with a little bit of comic book flair.
Yeah,
that makes sense. Like it's higher quality than just a comic book. It's up there. I mean, comparing that to like the Deadpool animations, I really dig these. I think this is like a much more rounded, from what I saw, animation package from Stern. I thought it was probably their best animation.
Well, they keep kind of getting better.
They do get better. I mean,
if you look at Iron Maiden, which, believe it or not, was like 2 years ago now. So, you know, Iron Maiden was good as far as the animations go. But then, you know, you move forward and you have Jurassic Park. And then they did the cool stuff with Deadpool, mm-hmm. With the 16-bit style. And then you come to this, and after Turtles, by the way, and I think, they just keep improving. So that's good for them, and good for all of us, especially. So I don't know. Do we think? I mean, are assets dead to Stern? Are like movie clips and TV clips just gone?
No. You're always going to have those.
You think so?
Why not?
What? Give me a property they're going to use that instead of their own animations.
Any property mm-hmm. that is a movie or TV show.
Jurassic Park.
Any movie besides Jurassic Park.
That is Ninja Turtles.
That's more based on.
It is, but yeah. But they did not use any of the cartoon, right? That's my
Starts
point.
Is brutal, but man, I love the punishment. Thank you, Ryan Utek, you bastard. So let's get caught up with
oh, we got stars.
We do have stars, so that's why I wanted to kind of talk about it.
Joseph Hood. Casey is shitting stars all over you, says Joseph Hood. Joseph Hood, is he the first person? No.
Billy YJ, drink bitches, sent 10 Jesus. Stars.
Oh, man. Guys, we were seriously joking about this.
Hey, it works.
Hang on. Carl Lutz, you guys are stars. Sent 10 stars.
Carl, thank you. Thank you.
John Cosson, money for the men. Sent 40 stars. Jesus, Dr. John.
Ari Jones sent 250 stars and sent us a little poop emoji. Thank you, Ari. Appreciate it,
Joseph
brother.
Hoods is the best so far. Shitting stars all over you.
Shitting stars all over you.
Joseph Hoods.
Money for the men. 40 stars.
Man, you guys are awesome.
250 stars, Joseph Hood. You guys, thank you so much. Thank you so much.
We really didn't expect that. That's totally unexpected and totally awesome of you guys.
Charles Thomas, you're 100% right. Without a doubt, Goonies would be not the Goonies without
Drew
clips.
And Ian love drinking, obviously, says Dr. John. You're right, Dr. John. True story.
It's how we cope with Mondays.
Life.
But yeah, no, that's that. I think there are properties that you would do a disservice to by just doing animations. Like a Goonies. Well, I don't think I really like this Jurassic Park animation.
Okay, but we need to talk about this because
I would rather have clips from the movie, but they didn't follow the damn movie.
We saw what happened with Jurassic Park.
It was Dino Adventureland.
Yes. And, you know, Deadpool. I know it wasn't based
on the movie. Comic booky. Yeah.
Fair enough.
90s fighting.
Fair enough.
You don't need
but
clips.
My point is, okay, so like you had the DMDs when you had like Game of Thrones, right, which wasn't that long ago. Ghostbusters, right? Wasn't that long ago. But now I think because we're in the LCD era and because those clips back then, they just said it, they were less expensive back then.
Right.
Because they didn't have to get all the people's permissions because they were dots. Like the old, even Last Action Hero, you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger, yeah, his image is on
there.
They
were fucking awesome dots.
No, they were kick-ass dots. But, and you could tell it was Arnold, but now with the LCD, if you want to do that, you need to get his permission. And they're not gonna do that. Beatles, they didn't get the rights to show. They got the rights to the songs, but they didn't get the rights to show the Beatles in concert, right?
I don't know how any of that works. Well, I'm talking from an asshole in a basement in Milwaukee here.
That's a unique perspective.
That perspective is telling me I need to see some more of these fucking live clips, guys. They did it in Munsters not too long ago, so. I mean, it's not totally dead.
Okay, but that was a 60s property that wasn't very expensive.
Oh, now you're... I'm telling you, there's going to be more times. I feel like where you're going with this is they're just going to animate everything going forward.
Yes, that's what
I'm telling you, there's other properties that it would be a disservice if they animated everything.
I don't disagree with that, but I'm saying they're going to do it.
I think it depends on the property. George Gomez is a smart man.
He is.
He's much smarter than me.
Guardians of the Galaxy, they had some assets.
Perfect example.
Yeah, that is a good example. Okay.
That would have sucked if it was all animated. Errol even though it was a comic book, but it was based on the movie. Sure. Therefore, you need the clips.
Aerosmith, a newer game. They didn't have any Aerosmith assets.
That was kind of new, though. They were
that was getting, the first one.
They were just getting off the...
But they did all animations. They didn't do a single asset.
But they were just getting started.
Mm. Okay, fair enough.
Fuck, that needs ice. All right, so... anyway, so... What are we doing? What are we talking about here?
Assets.
Assets. I love assets. All right, let's move on. Let's move on. So... At the end of the day, we were impressed with the live stream with Jack Danger. Jack Danger knocked it out of the park.
He did.
You know, how often do you get to see Jack Danger go up against, Raymond Davidson.
Keith Owen. I do want to point this out, and Jack, this is in no way a disrespect to you, and a lot of people pointed it out. Keith Owen and Raymond Davidson are obviously two of the best players in the world, and people are saying, like, this game kicked Jack Danger's ass. I saw a few times he threw up his hands and he goes, "Oh fuck!" and he like walked away because he lost his ball.
Yeah,
and
I was doing that with Pinball FX too.
Yeah, and Keith Owen and Raven Davidson, they're like explaining the game and they're going through it and they're making all the shots. And I'm like, "So what do you think about that? Do you think streams should do that, or should they have regular Joes like me and you doing it?"
No, people want to see shit.
Well, but they also want to see what a regular guy looks like.
No, they don't. Because remember what happened when us two regular guys were at the Wonka reveal?
Oh, that was terrible. That was terrible.
We just fucking...
Mm-hmm. Drained after 10 seconds.
Drained badly. Mm. Just when you get that new girlfriend and you get to see her butt for the first time. Drain instantly. Just unfortunate. And that's what we did with Wonka. Sorry, everybody, but that's the truth.
Mm.
I can't help it. It's a physical thing.
Would you guys give us more stars if we streamed?
Nobody wants to see that. Nobody wants to see someone because
everybody wants to see this.
All right. That's true. That's very true. Eh. But no, there's that whole point of it is they want to see different
Kaz
things.
Here. Sorry, Kaz is here. Kaz
hey, Kaz. How are you, brother? But yeah, you know, I don't know. They want to see things.
Dr.
They wanna...
John, see shit, not shit players.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they want to see shit.
Jesse J, why are you laughing? Are you laughing at my nipple reveal?
She she's becoming a big fan of your nipple reveal.
Jesse J, you're one of our Australian sisters. We love you.
All right, we love you. All right, so. Two thumbs up so far.
Yeah,
very impressive.
It very...
What do you guys think it? In chat, what do you guys think of the stream, Jack Danger, everything, the whole Avengers reveal? You guys think they did a damn good job with it?
Do you think 2 hours is too long? And do you think they should be showing the game? Or should they be taking the glass off and going through some mode things so people can see?
Way too many questions there. We just asked them like 7 questions.
Okay, let's start over. Okay.
Did you like it? Did you like the stream?
I'm getting a little more in-depth than that.
Nope. Just tell us what you liked. Boom. Done. Let's move on. All right. So we're just moving on along. So JJP. I'm hearing through the grapevine.
Ian got a special rumor today.
It's a unanimous.
Can we talk about it?
Rumor.
Will we get canceled?
We had a buddy say, "Are you really going to talk about this rumor?" Well, yeah, because we don't have facts.
He sent us the message, and he was legitimately concerned. He said,
"We don't have any facts. We just have rumors."
Are you going to say that on a live air?
This show is like, we are the dumbest show.
And we're like,
well,
first of all, we have 5 people listening to us right now.
Yeah, we made $5.60. We're legit, guys.
And we love all 5 of you guys.
And thank you for the $5.60. We are appreciative. But in all serious, fuck yeah, we'll share rumors. We hear something, we're going to pass it on to you. We're not going to fucking boast about it as it's fact, but rumor has it, JJP reveal their next game this Friday. And they will have games ready to ship by Friday.
So this Friday, as in 9, 16, 18, whatever it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hmm. So
18?
So 18. Before Deeproot reveals their shit, JJP is going to reveal their shit.
Yeah.
And
so
they're going to be ready to ship.
So what we're getting is JJP is going to reveal.
And this is from a very reliable source.
Yeah. So JJP's going to reveal.
Inside JJP.
I don't know. But That's why journalists, it does make sense though, because if Deeproot's going to release on Monday, why not steal the thunder a bit and release your information on Friday? So but it does kind of make sense.
No, it makes a lot of sense. Don't you think though, you know,
be able to ship away.
I hate to give Canada more credit, but you know, he's been saying
not the country.
No, the person, Canada. That they should have been giving out more tidbits to try to steal some of the thunder now.
I was shocked there was nothing, really.
That's what I'm saying.
There's like, little bits. There's little hints. Yeah, but... They're GNR hints.
Yeah, but it wasn't like, okay, this game's coming tomorrow. You know what I mean? Like Deeproot, I think, did it right.
Yeah.
For now, at least. What they've been doing so far,
a little bit.
I like that teaser.
Yeah, you know, I thought they were trying to go all viral with it. Remember, like... what was that movie? Cloverfield, where they had like fake websites and shit up, and they were trying this viral marketing, and it got everyone psyched up, and everyone thought a lion attacked New York.
Sorry, Kaz says, quick, Jersey Jack, call into the hotline to confirm.
Yeah. So
our hotline, 414, poor men are dumb.
@gmail.com. Something like that. So,
welcome, buddy. Welcome.
But no, I'm excited. If that's true, this is a fucking crazy month. This is going to be an awesome month for pinball.
This might be...
And podcasting.
This might be one of the best 30 days...
Yes.
...since we've been doing this, right? Yeah. By far, because you got Avengers. You still got the Turtles, you know, still on the heels of that.
Yes.
You got a potential GNR popping out this week.
Yep.
You got Deeproot coming in strong next week.
With their full reveal.
Yes.
This isn't going to be Raza in some prototype cab. We're going to see...
Now, let me ask you this. We'll get into Deeproot. We will get into Deeproot. Do they need to...
I feel like you froze there for a second.
I did.
You doing all right?
Do they need to have games ready to ship? Or will that just be a big misstep for them if they don't?
Who?
Deeproot.
Oh. Are we going into Deeproot?
We might as well.
Let's just get into Deeproot.
We're here. What are we doing?
Deeproot is going to be doing their reveal, we know, on Monday due to their teasers. So, is your
Jesse J 555 Drew's nipples? Best comment of the night so far. And then Dr. John, my Australian brothers and sisters, I love you guys. Dr. John follows it up with 414 dildos.
Yeah, that's.
Oh my God, you guys are awesome. Thank you guys. 555 Drew's nipples though. That's got some legs to it. Thanks, Jesse.
Only on the Poor Man's Pinball Podcast, where you can have Drew's nipples as a phone number and dildos.
Yes.
Yeah. Rick McClung, I thought viral marketing too.
Grow up,
for hidden stuff, wasted my time and felt more dumb than normal. Rick McClung, I agree with you 100%. Me too. I was hoping there'd be something else that was a deeper meaning, but no, it was just a date.
And then Kaz, kids, please ask your parents' permissions before you call 1-900-POOR-MAN. $1 per minute for sexy pinball talk.
Hey, do you like flippers? I do too. Do you like to hit a couple balls around? I do too. Tell me, what do you wear when you play pinball?
Do you wear Jockton's Pinshades and look at Drew's balls while you play?
If you want to know how to do that, look at episode 71 of the Poor Man's Pinball Podcast.
What is that called? ASMR? Oh, yeah. We love that talk.
Oh, yeah. We have a hotline now, Billy YJ. Yeah, we do.
Yep.
I've been waiting for Toy Story, Tim Lee. I don't know if it's going to be Toy Story. What do you think?
Well, it's not going to be Toy Story.
Guns N' Roses.
But based on what I'm hearing, though, Toy Story might not be far behind. You know, if they're set up, they're tooling up, they might release Guns N' Roses. They might start making them. Maybe they drop Toy Story for Christmas. That's a possibility.
How many games do you think they're ahead right now?
Designing. Like in the shoot, ready to go.
Yeah. Do you think Eric's on game number one, two, three?
I think Toy Story's done.
Yep.
And I think the next one's probably being buttoned up. Yeah. Would be my guess.
Yeah. I'd assume they're about two up now.
Yeah, you're right.
So after Toy Story, I think the other two are pretty much in the final stages. That's just a guess, but...
I've been saying this since I've been in this hobby.
Yeah.
I was going to say Deeproot, sorry. JJP needs to figure out how to get two games out a year, and they'll be okay.
Right.
So, anyways, flip my balls, baby. Thanks, Joseph Hood.
Yep, GNR is Friday. You're right, Charles Thomas. 100%. Friday is going to be the reveal, guys. All right, so, like I said, back to Deeproot. Do you think they're going to have games ready for launch? That, to me, is very interesting.
Yeah, well, I just think that if they, okay, they have this big reveal, right?
Right.
And they're ready to go. And they're like, okay, you know, here's Raza in its final form. And here's all the cool stuff.
The final transformation.
And then they're like, hey, you can buy this. There's 200 of them, 300, whatever it is, right?
Right.
And people go in and they buy them. What's going to happen if they can't get them for 6 months? Because even think, okay, Rick and Morty, right?
Did you think Deeproot had enough time to make them yet? I think it's been like 5 years.
That's been 5 years.
you almost feel like, well, they should be ready, right?
Here's
ship?
Here's my point. This is my reason why. Now follow me here,
fuck,
guys.
I believe Haggis already has more games made than Deeproot. Ooh. Prove me wrong, bro. Prove me wrong.
Way to go, Damien.
Love you, Damien.
So Spooky Pinball, right? Yeah. They've been in the game 6-7 years now, okay?
Yes, yeah.
And they release Rick and Morty, and everyone goes apeshit, and everyone buys it, right? And they sell out in 4 hours. That's awesome.
Yep.
And then after like a month or so, what started happening? People are like, I don't want to wait, right? I want to sell my spot. There's other shit, right?
That happens with every
Correct. That's my point. Well, so my point is, if Robert comes out and says, hey, here's Raza, it's awesome, and everyone's even like, this is super cool, but you might have to wait 5, 6, 8, 10 right. months. That might be a problem for
them. That's a big problem.
Yes.
Everyone thought the biggest question mark isn't necessarily the games, because we know they have some talent over there. It's manufacturing, right?
Here's a better... This is an intuitive Drew question. Are you ready for this?
He's
I'm
pumped,
pointing.
Kids.
I'm pointing. I'm pumped.
He's pumped. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just listening to this show, I just want to let you know that Drew is pumped. Okay. Go pumped. Ahead, Drew.
Okay. What
Don't if... ever do that again. He's flexing now. What He's if... looked like Kaneda for a second.
I'm not gonna show you my abs.
All right.
What if? What
you
if,
aren't wearing socks though.
Yeah. What if Raza comes out and they sell out instantly, and then that happens where they can't, you know, get them out like in a timely fashion? Are people gonna wait?
If they can't get Raza's out in a timely fashion, are they gonna wait? No, because I don't think there's that many people that want a Raza.
Okay, but like I said, no, it's a limited run.
We don't
run.
Know.
No,
it's you think it's limited?
It's a limited run. No, yeah. I think it will be.
Okay.
But those 200 people or 300 people, are they going to give Deeproot their money like Spooky? Because see, the thing...
What do you guys think out there in chat
okay,
land?
Okay, let us know, because the difference with Spooky is...
We're going to you next.
You know you're going to get your game, right?
Right.
Spooky, they're very trustworthy. You're going to get your game.
Right.
So the worry is not there that you're not going to get your game.
Right, I get it.
But now if you give your money to Robert and Deeproot, and they're like, we're going to make these games over the next 12 months, are you so sure? Let us know in chat.
Yeah, I mean, right? I trust the dude. They got the money. Well, it's not like...
But it's not about having the money. It's
just, kind of is.
Yeah, there's some of that.
Because you need at least financial backing. We know he has financial backing.
He does.
That's the key.
But you still need to produce the games.
I understand that.
Okay.
I mean, is your worry that your worry is not that they're not gonna make them because of financial issues, but just they just couldn't figure out manufacturing? Is that your worry?
Maybe.
Okay. Just wanted to clarify
right?
that.
Yeah, yeah. That's kind of
so
it.
More like manufacturing woes, yep. And they just can't.
Yeah,
make them.
Something comes
or it
up
takes forever.
Yeah,
or
yeah.
Supplies. Or...
Yeah, whatever. The stuff coming from China.
Oh, it can happen. Yeah, delays happen.
Yeah.
You know,
because like I said, everyone trusts Charlie and company. That I know, I might have to wait 2 years, but I'm going to get this game.
Well, here's another thing to think about too. So if it is a limited run, it is their first game. They're already bleeding.
We don't need another Lebowski debacle, Ricky.
Exactly.
We kind of talked about that. I think the money's there. They're not. He's not going to go bankrupt. But it's just a matter of can they?
Yeah,
make
those
games?
Two Dutch bastards had no money to begin with.
Yeah, I don't know those two Dutch guys, but Robert Mueller seems to have his stuff together.
Mr. Mueller.
So
yeah.
That's all.
What else we got?
Deeproot is so large, you'd expect delivery within a week.
I would assume so, yeah.
People understand Spooky is a small family company. Yes, exactly. But, okay, they have zero reputation, though. Who wouldn't trust J-pop? Oh, wait. Touche, John Arthur. Touche.
I guess my point, my whole fucking thing is, with this whole thing is Robert Mueller has the money, he has the backing, he has experience with certain manufacturing,
yes,
and they've had time to figure this shit out. So what I'm looking at and I'm hoping for is a clean launch, minimal issues, and just get us some product out the door. It doesn't have to be the day of.
No,
I understand it. It's their first launch.
You don't think they should have 50 games ready to go, though?
It would be a bonus. It would be a bonus. I would expect the first game. I give it a month to get the first games out.
How many?
I don't give a shit. Get them out. First truck leaves the show.
So 25 games in a month.
Sure.
Okay.
No, I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt.
That's reasonable.
Game two is going to be different. Game three will be different. Like, we've been talking about these fuckers for so many years now that we forget that they're a new company.
They've been in this longer than we've been in this.
Exactly.
And we've been in this a long time.
Anyway. So, no, I would say let's give them the benefit of the doubt. But let's get into something else. Unless you want to go into chat. What's going on in chat, buddy?
Brian Cosner says, Charles Thomas, Dutch Pinball game number two will come out. Charles Thomas, really. Cos, well, Deeproot paid all the previous rounds of customers and have a legal obligation to provide machines to those that ask for a pin. Yep, that's true. And Ryan Utek, he has Steve Bowden, the nicest guy in pinball. Yeah, you know
Steve's
what?
Steve's badass.
I want to talk to Steve Bowden. If someone can get Steve Bowden on this show, we would love that.
We can get him on. We could talk to him. You act as if, like, we need somebody to... He knows who we are.
I'm humble.
I talk to Steve.
I'm humble.
I message Steve.
No, I know. I have, too. We're just humble. That's all. We can get anybody on the show. Yeah. Hey, John Borg, you on the show? Silence.
Well, John Borg. Here's my John Borg story, all right? So, at Expo, this is the famous Expo where Drew puked in the urinal. Before he pukes in the urinal, we lost him. Me and Eric, we lost him for a while. Listener number five, I think he is, Eric. Anyway, doesn't matter. We lost Drew, and then all of a sudden we found him. And where is he? He's chatting up with John Borg. John Borg's drinking a beer. John Borg's super cool. So I'm like...
Oh, it was one of the best pinball moments of my pinball career.
And embarrassingly enough, I go up to John Borg. I introduce myself. I say, I love your games. And he's like, awesome. And then I go instantly into... I blanked. I forgot every one of his games. I forgot, except for Metallica. I knew he did Metallica, but I wanted to ask him a question on some of his other games. And I could not think of any fucking John Borg games at the time. So
awkwardly, Jesse J says, rub the nipples again. You can get whoever you want, Drew.
Come to me, John Borg. Come to me.
But here, at the end of the day, though, when I was blanking, there was that awkward silence. And what did I do to make it even worse? I busted out my phone. I tried to go on Pinside real quick to see which games were there. What games did he fucking do? God damn it. And then by the time I realized too much time had gone by, because I was drunk as shit too. You weren't the only one that was drinking that night. I just didn't throw up in a urinal. And I realized this has already gone so fucking south that it's just not. I said, John, I love you. I probably just walked away like.
The better quick story from that
was not good.
Was when we were.
I have messaged him since. I apologize.
We were in that same area, and Eric, tribe member number four or five.
Five, I think.
He saw Keith Elwin, and he yelled for Keith, and he goes, "Hey, Keith!
Hey, Keith!"
And Keith looked over, and he had nothing.
Eric was like,
"He just froze, and he didn't say anything."
Keith walked on by.
Yeah, that was the highlight, actually, of my expo. It was so simple and so stupid, but yeah, he yelled for Keith. Keith looked, and he was like, I don't know what to say.
John Cosson. Lucky it wasn't Steve Ritchie. We actually talked to Steve Ritchie at MGC that
year. We did, yeah.
It was cool.
Yeah, it was very cool.
Someone clip that. Ryan Utek, fuck off. All right, for a couple beers, I will act like about it. All right, Rick McClung, rub the nipples. All right. Okay, so let's move on.
Time to move on.
What do we got today? Over here, dude?
We're talking about Deeproot. We got a top five today, don't we?
We do have a top five here. Let's play the...
Do we have a cool top...
And now it's time for everyone's favorite top five.
All right, top five. Here we go. We have a top five today. On a piece of paper.
Is this like the Johnny Carson?
Top five reasons. No. Top
are we five best friends.
Yeah, we are. All right. This is gonna be top five things we'd like to see in the deep Deeproot reveal as far as technology innovations?
Yeah, this has less to do about the game itself and more to do with their cabinets and what they're trying to do. Yeah,
the innovations that we would like to see moving forward with not only Deeproot, but I guess everybody, just the to be industry. Honest. Yeah, the industry needs to kind of start following these things. I think we got a good list here.
Yep.
Or two lists.
So go ahead. What's your number five?
Now, my number five is a real simple one. No more soldering. I don't care. That's old school. We can get by soldering. We can get past soldering.
Yeah.
There shouldn't be an ounce of solder in any games anymore.
Doesn't your American Pinball, they have like terminals on the coils and stuff?
Haven't had to open it up because it's fucking stellar. Oh. Thank you, American Pinball.
Well, I know, but I saw some what company was it? Where they had like a coil.
Chat, help us out.
But then they had the connector. So you would just, you know, if you had to replace a coil, let's say, you'd get the coil. The wires are already, they might be soldered on, but there's a connector.
Right.
Where you can just pop in so you don't got to pull out your soldering iron. It's very right. easy.
Just in general. Not Which, that I don't yeah. like soldering.
No, I'm fine with soldering.
I actually enjoy
it.
Soldering. Yeah, it's However, fun. I think let's move past it. The technology has moved past soldering. We can
I
do
agree
this.
With that.
We can do this, kids. Together.
I agree with that.
Hold my hand. We don't need solder anymore.
And the answer is, like I said, you have components that are soldered, but then they have connectors on the end, so you can just plug them in. Yes. So, I mean, you could just, well, whatever. It can be done. You're right. Good one, man. That's
Thanks.
Good.
Thank you.
So my number five, built-in Pinstadium lights.
Mm.
And or just, I guess, side rail lights. Mm-hmm. Like, sorry, Scott, they don't have to be Pinstadium branded, but I think if every manufacturer, Scott's going to hate me.
You're fine.
You know, if you...
he only paid us nothing.
Bill Webb from Special Wind Lit, when he did his Whirlwind cabinet, he routed out the side of his cabinet.
Yep.
And he put the Pinstadium lights in there so you could raise the play field without doing that, right?
Right.
Now... What if you just had your GI lighting like that, where it's just like a strip or some bulbs or whatever, but it was like embedded into the side, right?
Ooh.
So yeah, it might not even be that. It might just be some regular sockets, but they're embedded into the side.
God, that's sexy.
So it lights up the whole thing, right?
Yeah.
And if you want to just be stern and say, hey, we're just going to route this out. If you want to put Pinstadiums in there, you can. Or you can buy our option. That's cool, too. And then Scott would love that. Stern would love that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I think that's cool.
Yeah.
So just a lighting option along the whole length of the machine.
Good number five, dude.
Cool.
All right. My number four.
Sorry, Scott. Love you.
Love you, Scott. Number four, hassle-free rubber replacement. Meaning, I want to make sure, because I had to replace the rubbers on the Oktoberfest.
Oh, we're best friends.
And it sucked. There was so hard to get to shit. It's time we had more modular components on fucking pinball machines.
Kind of like we're talking about with the coils and shit.
Yeah, let's think outside the box here and make assembly and disassembly super simple for everybody so they can all do this. Because now that this hobby is moving away from the arcades and into people's homes, let's make it more friendly for everybody that needs to replace rubbers and not... so damn tedious. Now, so yeah, single level playing field, super easy. I get that. Older games, super easy. But now with these newer games coming out, it's not easy getting to some of these rubbers.
How long did it take you to replace that one rubber on October
2nd? 2 days.
No, it was literally like several hours.
Oh, the one rubber that was buried?
The one rubber.
It took me 2 days to replace all the rubbers. There's still parts that I couldn't even get to the rubbers. But the one part that was really frustrating was a bitch to... take apart.
And I don't care who you are, what you think about pinball, like that just shouldn't happen. That sucks.
We should make it as easy as possible. It should be more modular. Yes. A few screws should hold an entire section.
I'm going to get to more of that. So my number four, a little different, a better way to break down the machine.
Oh, but it's still the same. Yeah.
Well, I'm going to get to something else a little more specific to what you were talking about, but I just think, you know, we've kind of talked about this on the show before, and it might be sacrilege because everyone loves their heads lined up and they love their cabinets lined up and all this stuff. And I get that. And I'm kind, you know, I think it's fine. But, you know, we have these huge cabinets and these huge back boxes that house a single circuit board now.
Yeah.
In the old days, even going back to like Metallica from 2013, you had like literally four circuit boards in the back.
Right.
It literally filled up the whole back box. Now, you open up a brand new Stern, there is one tiny circuit board, and that's it.
That's it?
That's literally it. There's a tiny circuit board, a power supply, and an LCD. So I think it can be changed. And like I said, people are going to hate me. Send me hate mail, poormanspinball@gmail.com. Let me know how much you hate me. That's fine.
And the subject line say, Drew, you're nuts.
Yeah, but, you know.
I like my big heads.
Yeah. No, I think it can be done differently. Go ahead. What do you got?
So was that breaking down a machine? Or are you talking about the pinball norms?
Maybe they have retractable legs. Maybe you don't have to unbolt the legs anymore.
Okay.
Oh, that I just thought of that right now. Like, what if...
Genius.
What if the leg wasn't solid steel and you could just, it was plastic or something, like some hard composite plastic? I know. I'm breaking the mold, right? Look at him.
People don't like I know.
But like you
this could, is supposed to be a simple top five. Drew's changing the game kids.
I'm changing the world. The pinball world.
Everyone that's older than 35 just fucking just shit themselves. Totally. Good job, dude.
But, yeah. What if you didn't have to unbolt the legs? Go ahead.
All right, so my number three, built-in Pinstadium lights.
Guys, we did not plan this.
I will say this about the built-in Pinstadium lights, what I like
did
about
you really
the
write
idea.
That down?
Yeah, number three, built-in Pinstadium lights.
Ian and I love each other so much. I know. Jesus fucking
I guess
Christ.
I guess what I would be excited about the proposition. So what are Pinstadiums? You know, if you really think about them, they're interactive for every game because it ties into the GI and the flashers.
And the flashers, yeah.
But what if the Pinstadiums were built.
Jeremy Schmidt says, Drew, you nuts.
Yeah.
Thanks, Jeremy. Love you, brother.
But what if Pinstadiums were built game specific? Meaning this set is for Whirlwind.
Sorry, or... Pete says, is this Poor Man's Pinball Podcast or Lazy Man's Pinball Podcast? Go ahead. It's Lazy Man's.
Fuck you, okay? Pete.
Yeah. Go ahead.
No, I'm talking about just what... I'm talking about if they were to do a built-in Pinstadium lights, they can make it game-specific, meaning it could do specific things.
Oh, sure.
Spotlights.
No, you could...
Everything that you could think of, you could probably put on that rail for very interactive lighting that's game-specific.
I'm going to
say
tied
into the code.
Not just
GI and flashers, which I know is code-based.
It sucks in today's world that you buy a brand new game and the playfield isn't lit up.
Yeah, I get it, man.
It just sucks.
So that's my number three. What's your number three?
My number three.
Lazy Power Man's Pinball Podcast.
This one, they've kind of done, some modders have done, self-leveling legs. Mm. We were kind of talking about the legs, maybe that fold up or whatever.
Yeah.
But they have those, hydraulic legs and stuff. Because, you know, you go into your pinball machine, you got to lift up this big, heavy fucking cabinet. You got to do all these different things. And then you got to level your legs.
Right.
You know.
Level your legs.
Yeah. Well, if you had little modulators on there, you could literally push a button, you know, and have them like air controlled or something. Yeah. Sure, that'd be cool, right? So
you put them on your plastic legs.
And... Yeah, my plastic legs that no one wants. So, you know, here we are.
All right, my number two. This is simple. I don't know why. I mean, this used to be done. But my number two is I want toppers with every one of their games, Deeproot, free. No charge. It's built into the cost
just
of the game.
Just Deeproot or everybody?
Well, I would like everybody. I know Stern's not going to fucking do it with their $900 toppers, but I think toppers should be part of the game. It should be not an accessory what you would have to spend money on. I think it should come in the packaging. In the game.
I agree. And like you
said, I think if Deeproot is trying to be different than everybody else, I think Deeproot should really think about putting that as part of the cost of the game. Toppers for every game.
Nope. Toppers for everybody.
Vote for Ian.
You get a topper, and you get a topper.
You get a topper. You get a topper. You get a topper.
Is your name Zach Manny?
Everyone gets a topper. Well, no, Zach's like, you give me 900. You give me 900. You give me 900. Everyone gives me 900.
Did you see
Love
that?
Love you, Zach.
did you see that message? Somebody sent us in our inbox at the Poor Man's. They were like, I think I saw the Elvira topper at the Halloween store. And it was like
$40.
$50.
Yeah. Ouch.
So funny. My number two is kind of what Ian talked about earlier, alluded to with the rubbers. Easier playfield access top and bottom. I want to see it on a spit, like a rotisserie.
Ooh.
right? Yeah. Imagine if you had a rail that ran the whole length of the playfield from mm-hmm. from the flippers all the way up to the top, and then you could open up the glass and spin that thing.
Yeah.
Right? Because you gotta fix something, right?
Yeah.
You spin it, it's right there. You could make the cables long enough, right? So you could do that. You either spin it left or spin it right. And then to your point about the rubbers, you would have, you know, I bought those stupid little rubber tops for my firepower instead of the nuts.
Yeah.
Right? Because, like, we use these nuts in this hardware, and these little rubber things cost nothing. You put them on there, you can literally pull one off, pull two of them off, and pull off your plastic.
Mm-hmm.
And then the rubber's right there.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, getting to the rubber's easier, getting to the lights easier. I think that's necessary.
Okay, perfect.
So there you go.
And my number one.
Number one.
Oh, I forgot what it was.
Read your notes, buddy.
Playfield is tough as steel. Let's get done with the playfield issues. Let's make it where... Listen, you want to do it? Let's do it. We'll just call PPG, okay? They're nationwide. They got PPG in Chicago. I know they do. PPG is the people that make Diamond Coat.
Ian doesn't even sell this shit.
PPG still can make Diamond Coat. Like... People think that Diamond Coat, that clear coat that they used in
Carl Lutz, Playfield Access. Yes. Thanks, Carl Lutz. Thanks for verifying me.
Diamond Coat didn't disappear, guys. It's still around. You can still get it. PPG still makes that shit. Nobody pays for it. Nobody buys it. Bring it back. I don't even care if it's Diamond Coat. Something as strong as Diamond Coat.
Is it $25 more Playfield? Is it $50?
Will we pay for it?
That's what I'm asking.
I would pay for it.
Well, no.
It would be more like $3 a play field.
Are you serious?
Oh, yeah.
So why don't they just charge us an extra $10 and do it?
Clear coats go so far, right? I mean, square footage-wise.
Stern, are you listening? We haven't done this in a long time. Stern, are you listening?
Stern, are you listening? Clear coats go so far. So a 5-gallon bucket of clear coat.
We're talking to you, Stern.
George, I see you, George Gomez.
Come on, George. I know you watch this shit.
But no, I would.
It if goes, George Gomez showed up in chat right now and said,
"You know,
sorry, go ahead."
No, I'm just saying, a clear coat, 5-gallon bucket of clear coat, like something like a diamond plate, will take.
Mike Williams says diamond coat does not pass the modern VLC requirements.
For
he's
what?
He's a chemist. He works on this shit all day. With your shit, by the way.
Okay, the VOC requirements are one thing. He can spray that shit in Wisconsin, no problem. So that's how far away. Set up a shop in Wisconsin.
Uh-oh, Mike Williams, there's some words here.
Yeah, just set it up in Wisconsin. VOC restrictions in Chicago are strict.
Oh, you think that's why?
But they're not getting their play fields from Chicago. They're not spraying in-house. They're spraying them, where are they spraying them? Germany or some shit? Or... Isn't Mirko based in Germany?
I think so.
Yeah. So where are they getting these sprayed? They're not spraying them in house.
Well, when I was talking, Mike Williams, he works in that kind of field, and he was talking about in Europe. That's the tough problem.
Yeah, I'm just saying. Well, fuck Europe and set up a shop, your own shop.
Ricky McClung, if I was George, I wouldn't watch this. Ricky, you're here.
That's hurtful, Ricky. Really hurtful.
Yeah.
But no, I'm just saying. There's VOC restrictions are different in every state. You can find a state that has very low VOC restrictions. But Wisconsin doesn't have VOC restrictions.
My
you can spray that shit in Wisconsin.
My logical brain always says, why don't they do it then?
That's what I'm saying. Why not?
Mm.
They must get such a fucking deal on them. They don't want to. It would be too expensive to set up their own shop. But they can do it. They can do it.
Okay.
And Wisconsin's, what, half hour away, an hour away? So they can
They could come here, spray it, get them done.
It's a lot quicker and a lot less distance than freaking Germany.
They could set up a little shop here and say, hey, we just want you to do 5,000 play fields. And,
yeah. Simple shop.
Sure. It wouldn't take much.
Doesn't take much. Yeah. Put a spray booth in it and you're done.
Huh. Because that does for a company like Stern, it doesn't seem very expensive.
It's not.
Well, then why aren't they doing it?
I don't understand why they do what they do. It doesn't make sense to George get playfields from other places.
We need you on our show.
VOC restrictions in Wisconsin are we can still do as nasty as we want. So we can get pretty nasty with the ship.
Interesting. All right. My number one. You ready?
You're number one, dude.
easier to remove glass. Make it hood-like. Pick that shit up.
Oh, I just see so many broken glasses for some reason.
No, because think about it. You know, removing glass, it's not difficult, but it's a pain in the ass at the same time, right?
All
right. So I'm just thinking, if you have it built into the cabinet, where you either A, lift it up like a hood, or B, you know, lift it over.
Okay.
But it's hooked into the frame, basically. You don't have to actually remove the glass. Because, you know, people have broken glass. You see those pictures on Pinside all the time, right?
Yep.
I'm always worried. Like, I remove my glass a lot. I do a lot of shit with my pinball machines, right? Because I buy lots of stupid dolls and I put them in there. Well, one day I'm going to break a fucking piece of glass, and then what?
Twin Win has a hood, according to Ricky McClung. Twin Win.
What's Twin Win?
I'm assuming that's a pinball machine.
Ricky, you also said George wouldn't watch this, and that's completely false. He's here right now. He's just lurking.
He's lurking, totally.
George Gomez, show yourself.
All right, so let's look at this Twin Win here.
Uh-oh, we're looking at it. Joseph Hood, Drew, that is your number one? That's dumb, no offense. Thanks, Joseph Hood. Well, I want, I don't know. I mean, 1 through 5 is always kind of tough, but I don't know. What, Joseph Hood, what's your number one? Jesse J, that's true laziness, my dudes. Oh, Jesus. It takes 2.5 seconds to get glass off. Wow, you guys are being ridiculous right now. Okay.
The benefits of doing this shit live.
Drew has amended his number one. My number one, I crossed off my number three before, so here it is. Upgraded sound system. There you go. That is my new number one. Put a badass sound system in there. Is that better for you, Jesse J and Joseph Hood? Man, are you kidding me?
I guess so, buddy.
All right. Highway has the hood design. And okay, you had others, but your number one was bad. Jesse J smiles. Okay, thanks, guys.
Drew's idea, Carl. Thank you, Carl.
Thanks, Carl.
I'm glad he won't cry about it after we shut this down.
Oh, man.
All right, so this is what we're going to do, guys. We're going to introduce a new tribe member, but before we do that, let's do a cocktail break because I need ice.
Cool.
So we'll see you in a bit. All right, we're back, guys. We're back. All right, so Drew is fine. He's making it. All right, so we're going
to tell you people. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Okay.
But we're going to do our tribe introduction today.
We got a good one today. I'm excited about this.
Another good. They're all good. We love our tribe. Should we do a... Here is our current tribe list. Let's get into that. Last time we brought in Matt Michaels.
There are 32 buttholes in our tribe. Look at that group. That's a good group of people.
It's all lovely people. Yeah. All lovely people.
I would hang out with almost all of them.
One cooler than the next. I don't know about number 19. I don't know about number 4.
I was going to say, there's a few, but yeah, you know.
Number 14 is a prick. But other than that, good group.
How do you get into the tribe, Ian?
Oh, we have the four pillars of excellence.
Four or five.
There's five pillars of excellence. Sorry. Fourth one is always so iffy on me. So number one, like us on Facebook. Super simple. Number two, and especially follow us on Facebook because then you get the notification when we go live. So do that. Make sure that's
and I think it's
locked
give
and loaded.
Us, give us lots of stars.
Yeah, that's number five. We just threw that out there. No.
Give us 1 million stars.
All right. Number two is to interact with us. Doesn't matter if it's email or Facebook messages. Just let us know you're there and do it more than once, you know, because sometimes.
Jessie J, sorry, she says one lady. Yep, because we had trouble finding women that liked our podcast.
Yeah, it's happening, though. We're getting things together. Yeah. We're making it work.
Therese is awesome, by the way.
Tish is the coolest. Mm-hmm. So at least we have one of the coolest ladies in pinball.
Jessie J, you can get there, too.
Yes, you can.
You just got to follow the pillars.
And you're doing great. Number three is help us grow our podcast. A mention on a podcast, Jessie J. Or doing whatever you can to help us grow our podcast.
She says, this is an outrage. I'm going to get myself inducted out of sheer spite.
Yes, that's fine.
That is the attitude we want.
You're in. pillar number four is no media members, but that's kind of iffy. We're not following it strictly, but we're
biggest names we try to keep out just because we
big personalities like Franchi, but he got in.
Yeah. He wiggled his way in with his skinny body.
Yeah. And he helped us with our logo. So he got in.
Yeah. We love you, Franchi.
We love you, Chris. And then pillar number five, top secret, only Drew and I know. So it is what it is. So without further ado, let's do our tribe intro.
Thank you, sir. May I have another?
Poor man's pinball tribe.
Thank you, sir. May I have another?
Poor man's pinball tribe.
Thank you, sir. May I have another?
Poor man's pinball tribe.
Right now, yeah!
New tribe member is, did it come up? Yep, here we go. New tribe member is Frieden Liebe is one of the coolest pinball personalities out there right now. She has a fantastic Facebook group. It's called the Pinball Super Friends. So if you are not familiar with this, please go ahead and join that group. Her mission statement, and I'm going to read it kind of verbatim a little bit here, to seek to make arcade culture accessible to all players, player of color players, female identifying players, trans players, non-binary players, gender non-conforming players, disabled players, children players, all players. That means changing the conversation about games, art, arcades, culture, and the norms. Let's change the arcade as we know it, and the more accessible we make the arcade environment, the longer it will thrive. Pinball for all. I love that last bit, pinball for all, but I love it all. So meeting her and talking with her, she is a fantastic individual, and I love her message. She's very anti-bullying. She just wants pinball to be accessible.
She's
and she
awesome.
Wants arcades to be accessible.
Yeah, I love that. I'm not going to get too... What's the word? Sentimental here. I have a special needs child. I don't talk about it very much, but just for her being inclusive with everyone, that is so cool to me, and she deserves a spot in our tribe. So we welcome you with open arms.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, yeah. So she is a relatively new to the industry, or the new to the hobby. She really started playing around with the pinball machines in, around 2018.
Which means she already knows more than us.
Yeah, she actually really does like her. One of her passions is actually fixing up the machines. So anything from cosmetics. So she does touch-ups on the artwork. I'm sending you my playfields. She works on all the machines that she... She basically wants all pinball machines to live much longer lives than they're intended. And she, whenever she gets her hands on a game, she wants to make it better than when it was, you know, before. So everything I talked to her about is just freaking fantastic. And I think she should get definitely more credit for what she's trying to do there on the Facebook world.
And she's here right now.
Oh, hey.
Welcome so much to Tribe. She's Tribe member number 33.
It's a good number.
You are 33 of 2,500. There are 2,500 Poor Man's listeners, and you are number 33. So you should be very thankful for that. We appreciate you being here. Thank you so much.
Yeah, and this past month, she's been working on Safecracker. How cool is that? Safecracker.
That's a unique
one. I'd love to get my hands on a Safecracker.
That's one of those, like... I'm going to call it a novelty machine that everyone needs to experience. Yeah, cool. Super cool.
Very cool. Welcome to the tribe. Welcome to the tribe.
Welcome very much.
We have an applause button. Hold on. Let's bust that shit out.
Every time we do that, I feel silly because I'm like, just push the damn button.
Well, welcome.
Yeah, be lazy like Drew with his glass.
Oh, boo-hoo.
Sorry. Jesse J said the next episode of Jesse J's Pinball Adventures is going to be called Drew's Nipples. If you do that, Jesse J, you will be well on your way to becoming a tribe member. I mean that, but you need to put it up there for everyone.
No, Ryan C's like, where is this coming from?
No context, okay? I just wanted to say Jesse J's Pinball Adventures episode number, I think you're on 7 or 8, Drew's Nipples.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll talk about it. Okay.
We'll talk about it.
So
let's talk about those things.
Frieden, how do we say that?
Frieden.
Liebe.
Liebe, yep.
Welcome to the tribe.
Welcome to the tribe.
Thank you so much for being
here. So happy to have you. We will be, once this episode posts on Wednesday, we will send you an invite to the actual tribe. The secret pinball tribe, the Poor Man's Pinball Tribe.
Tribe member Mike Williams says, I'd call it a pain in the ass machine. Fred Hopkins says, Safecracker is awesome. Yes, it is awesome.
Yeah, very cool. I've never played a Safecracker. I have not either.
I've looked at it. I've seen it. Every
time I usually play as a dangerous cracker.
Really? That was like the worst dad joke. I love it. Dad joke episode. Too cool.
I've never played a Safecracker.
No. Have we? They didn't even have them at the shows.
Didn't they have it at the...
They might have had an expo.
They had it at Expo. I just never got it. There was people in front of it.
Yeah.
I think it was there.
That's one of those games that everyone wants to play. It's on their
Absolutely.
List.
Absolutely. Yeah, super cool. All right. So let's get into our mailbag. Mailbag. All right. We have a mailbag thing. It's too much. There's too many buttons now.
Eddie's Mail Call.
All right, we have a couple. We have a very special one. So I'm going to read this. It's rather long, guys, but it's sentimental, and I love it. To give you some background on this, so I don't know. When was this? A few months ago. It was last fall, I believe. Mr. Pete Quint, I think he's number 14.
Tribe member number... Who gives a shit?
We love you, Pete.
I feel like Bob Uecker in Major League.
So he has a band, and it's the Nacho Street Band, and they actually were trying to raise money with Project Pinball, in coordination with Project Pinball, to put a pinball machine inside a Ronald McDonald Land house.
Hi, Tish.
So what we did was Drew and I, we were matching donations. And we were able to put up a nice little bit of money for them. But they were also getting help from a lot of different people. This is a huge team effort. Nacho Street Band was playing all over the place. And So he was able to cut a check. They were able to do it. So he wrote us a nice little note here, and I'm going to read it verbatim. Here we go. Ready?
I'm ready.
I'm going to take a sip here now that I have this nice cold drink.
With our nice glasses.
Plus, we'll build a little tension there. All right. Dun, dun, here dun. We go. Greetings, buttholes.
Of course it starts out that way.
This is Pete Quint, tribe member number 14, with an exciting announcement. The Nacho Street Band has done it. We met our fundraising goal and now have enough money to place a pinball machine in the Ronald McDonald House of Central Ohio. The band wanted to personally thank you for your support and contributions to the cause. A special shout out to Therese Edwards, tribe member number 31, Tish, for her wisdom, encouragement, and continued support in Columbus. Couldn't do it without you, Tish. Now, due to the stupid coronavirus, the Ronald McDonald House is closed to everyone but residents and staff, so it will, could be quite some time before we can place a machine on location. With that said, the band wanted to get your feedback on what machine you think families would enjoy at the Ronald McDonald House. Ultimately, the decision will come down to approval from the facility, but that doesn't mean we can't start brainstorming. My guess is that a table like Stern's Playboy may not fly. Just spitballing here. If you have time and want to shoot us a suggestion, please head over to the Nacho Street Band Facebook page. Give us a like and let us know what machine you would put in the Ronald McDonald House. Please remember that the band's Facebook page is family friendly, so please refrain from posting the typical memes you're used to seeing on the poor man's page.
What does that even mean?
Dude, I know what you're saying.
Josh Mudd, you're not allowed to go there and post anything.
You're right. Yeah. I'm looking at you, Josh Mudd, and Christopher Franchi. See, he already knew. Again, a huge thank you to all the poor men and women listening out there for your support. We've made a difference and surely will bring smiles to the faces of the kids for years to come. So the beautiful thing about Project Pinball is they maintain the machines for life.
Yeah.
And that's the key here.
We are super happy to have been part of that. We contribute to the raffles. We do that. I've contributed thousands of dollars to those raffles. I've never won. Thanks. Mm. But such a good cause. They do good work.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I'm giving Natural Street Band a round of applause.
Should we give them some cheese slices?
Give them some cheese slices.
You got cheese, kids.
Super cool. We're glad we could help. We're going to be doing more stuff like that. Like I said, we like to do it because, you know, that's what this is about.
Yeah, it's all about fun, family, friendship, drinking. Well, not so much that, but, you know, and having fun.
And then at the end of the day, you guys send us memes about Batman's dick. But whatever. I digress.
It happens. All right.
So, great job.
What games would you put in a Ronald McDonald House? First thing that came to mind was something like a Whitewater or...
Well, I just think any game...
Or if we go with a newer game, what's some of the newer games? Hot Wheels would be a good one.
Hot Wheels would be a good choice.
That would be really cool, I think.
You know what? Turtles.
Or Turtles.
Oh, it's a gas kicker, though. You don't want to do that.
Yeah, sorry. I'd say Hot Wheels is more approachable.
Yeah.
My vote's Hot Wheels.
I would say Hot Wheels. Otherwise,
how about you guys in chat? What do you think?
Deadpool would be a good one.
Yeah, Deadpool's a fun one.
Deadpool. You know, anything from Stern the last few years. I mean, Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah, that'd be fun, too.
Yeah, Guardians of the Galaxy actually would be my vote. So, oh, thanks, Billy YJ. He sent us stars. He's the one to help set up our stars. So.
Yeah, thanks, Billy.
Irony.
Our tip cup isn't working, but that's all right. We'll fix that later.
Yeah, I mean, can you think of a game that a Stern game recently that wouldn't go good there? I mean, they're all...
No.
No. Like I said, I think Guardians or... those are my choices. Jurassic Park. Jurassic Park Pro would be a good one.
Yeah.
You know, if you're going, there's a lot of good choices. Willy Wonka.
What do you guys think out there? Ooh, Wonka would be great.
Forget JJP. Willy Wonka would be a fun game.
Get a Wonka.
The kids. Therese Edwards wrote Willy Wonka. There you go.
Yeah, that's a good one. What else we got?
Theme Not Right for Deadpool. Well, kids like it. But yeah, I think Willy Wonka or Guardians would probably be my choice. Like I said, Turtles would be okay, but that game's a little hard. So
should we read the... The Jason Crawford email.
Yes.
Yeah, this was a pretty fun one. We had this week. This was like, I don't think this is a legit thing.
Oh, this is hilarious.
But it was awesome. I don't know if it was a language barrier thing or if it was a bot. But this was from Jason Crawford, this email. Hello, sales. My name is Jason Crawford, and I came across your company on a potential purchase of pinball. I will appreciate a link or a catalog to your pinball.
Kaz sent us 100 stars.
So that's exactly word for word how we phrased that. Thank you, Kaz, by the way. Drew Bovair responds, hello, Jason. We are not a pinball company, but a podcast and internet show. Are you looking to purchase a machine, as I do have several for sale? Regards, poor man. And then Jason Crawford replies, what is the price? And Drew says, I have a firepower for $2,300. Jason says, Jason, you sound like a bot. Are you a bot, dude? And then he goes into, in all caps, can you kindly get me a quote for 3 pieces of the firepower for $2,300 with tax, without shipping? Thanks.
Yes, it'll be $2,300 times 3.
Three pieces of the firepower.
Please buy 3 pieces of my firepower.
Could I have 3 pieces of the firepower for $2,300? His words. It was the fucking funniest thing.
You gotta love those spam bots.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesse's Jay said Waz would have the same problem then. Oh, kids won't have any idea what Wonka is, says Billy YJ.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, man.
Waz, maybe. But you know what? Waz and Wonka, though, I think would resonate with the kids. Right?
Okay. Yeah.
Right? If you put
magical.
Yeah, if you put a Waz or a Wonka in front of kids, I think they'd be okay.
We'll see.
I don't know.
Yeah.
So it's tough. Kosner, I know you're upset. You're not in the tribe yet. You will be someday. Sent 100 stars.
That's awesome. Thanks, guys.
Yeah.
So another email here. Neil W. sent us this one regarding the dilemma of nature calling while playing. So he's referring to our anonymous email last week about what happens when you are playing pinball and you have to take a shit. And do you go for the GC and shit your pants, or do you just let the ball drain? So this is his solution.
This has been a topic of conversation all week, by the way.
People care.
Yeah, this wasn't like a one-off. Like, everyone got involved in this
conversation. I always thought, you know, for solving the shit.
No, you know what? Like, I kind of knew that, but I never really thought of it when I'm in the moment. So, yeah, I'm going to start opening my coin door a lot because the wife will yell at me, and I'm like, what? And then I'm like, oh, shit, just open the fucking coin door. If you're at home, you can go change your clothes if you have an accident, says Brian Kosner.
All right, sorry, we lost you there. Yeah, shit or net. Well, you missed all of that? Aww. So, all right, I'll go into it again. What the hell? So he basically said modern games, Stern games, you know, you can use the coin door ball saver. You can have that setting turned on. So when you have to take a shit, you can open up your coin door and the ball will drain or whatever and won't count as a lost ball. And when you put the coin door back on, it will auto plunge or whatever and your game will
go on.
Can I ask a stupid question, though? The shitter riddle is solved. Open up your coin doors.
Why doesn't Stern, though, any company, just have a pause button?
Where's your top five list? Oh. Replace that with the glass opening up.
Okay.
I want a pause button.
Yeah.
I want a shitter button.
For all you guys, my number one, forget the glass, because I'm seriously okay with that. I want a shitter button. I want a pause shitter button on my game.
Drew's been wanting a shitter button for years.
True story. Jesse J, you can quit making fun of me now.
All right. Cool. All right. So what do we got left? That's it.
That's
We're done with mailbag.
We did good. Right.
So, Drew, what did you learn today?
I learned that Jesse J loves my nipples.
Yeah, I do too, though. It's not nothing. It's nothing new, man.
No,
people love your nipples.
My nipples are a real thing.
Yeah, I learned that people don't like lifting the glass like a hood. So
fuck.
I learned people were pretty harsh.
Upset about that. It was
just two people.
I learned that.
I think
people,
you're overreacting a bit.
Yeah, but it's good for ratings.
It is good for shock and awe.
People hate my glass hating.
I learned that Zach likes to give out toppers for $900.
He does.
You get one. All right, so that's it. Let's wrap her up. Guys, yeah. Did you have fun today?
Oh, we had a lot of fun.
All right, so we should probably play the flipping out ad. We didn't do that in the middle of the show, but we'll... Was that Zach that just gave us
some more money? Billy YJ just sent us 200 stars.
Thanks, Billy. We appreciate
Drew
you, brother.
Needs nipple rings.
So what we're thinking of, guys, for the next episode, so save your money on these stars. So what Drew and I are going to do for the next episode, we've been toying around with this, but I think what we're going to do is do shots. So every, we'll have a price list, but we're thinking a shot would be, you know, like $5 or whatever. Mm-hmm. And we'll each do a shot for $5. Mm-hmm. That's $2.50 a shot. So that's not bad.
Nope.
So is someone trying to get us to do a shot already?
Carl Lutz, 100 stars. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Carl. So that's what we're going to end up doing, I think, for next week. So what, for the time being, though, thank you very much for the stars, guys. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, you guys came out in spades today.
God, I love you
No
guys.
Pun intended. Jesus.
So what we're going to
do. We were half joking about all this.
I think we're going to do something fun with the stars. Mm-hmm. I think we're going to try to make it so it's not you guys just throwing it like we're strippers.
It's like a tip. Wow.
Don't do it. They will put stars in their jars just to keep you with that shirt on, buddy.
Hey, it's going to cost 10,000 stars to keep Drew's shirt on. That is the new price.
That's awesome. All right.
We really appreciate you guys. No, it'd be like a tip, basically.
Yep.
Like you're like, hey, I want to tip the bartender kind of thing.
We'll figure it out. Yeah. We'll have a whole menu for next week, and it'll be fun to do. So
Lee gave us one star.
Thanks,
Jesse
Lee.
Jesse J says, take my money.
Take my money now. So
are you saying you want my shirt to stay on, Jesse, or off? I don't get it.
I just... Maybe she's talking about the shots, because I think that'll be fun, because people are probably going to want to see us get extremely drunk.
Oh, so it'll be great.
It will be fun.
The tip jar is working, says Billy YJ. We'll pull our money for one episode and just watch circus. Yes, you will watch a circus.
Perfect. All right. Sure.
Love it, guys.
Thanks, guys, very much. Have a great rest of your week. We will talk to you next week with a JJP reveal and a Deeproot reveal.
We will have all that stuff for you and more next week. Thank you guys for tuning in. We will see you soon.
Yep. Bye-bye.
Love you guys.
The views expressed on this podcast don't necessarily reflect the views of our sponsors. Obviously, they don't really care as much as we do about buttholes and what's inside them. So thanks for listening, guys. Have a great day. Bye-bye.